It's the Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Senate Republican Caucus. I'm Tracy Ellis. Here are some of the things that happened this week in Olympia. The state Senate pays tribute to the late Senator Doug Erickson. The Senate adopted a memorial resolution honoring Erickson. Senate Republican leader John Braun.
Senator Doug Erickson was a man of very firm principle. Guided by those principles, he showed up here every day to make our state better for his family and families across the state of Washington.
Erickson died on December 17th. The Ferndale Republican represented Whatcom County's 42nd legislative district for nearly 23 years. Senator Simon Sefcik was appointed to fill the remainder of Erickson's term.
He cared tremendously for his community. He cared about his Whatcom County. He cared about his Washington state, this evergreen state, our evergreen state. And he was willing to fight for the people of Ferndale and Bellingham and Linden every single day.
Erickson joined the State House of Representatives in 1999 and moved to the Senate in 2011. Crashes that killed two Southwest Washington tow truck operators and a pair of stranded motorists prompts new legislation in the state Senate. Last year's deadly accidents hit home for Senator Jeff Wilson.
Prior to being a senator, I've actually worked and engaged a number of tow truck companies and recovery companies. These two companies that suffered these losses were no strangers to me, all having families, and they're deeply going to be missed.
The Longview Republicans' bills aim to improve accident scene safety by enhancing visibility of tow trucks and reinforcing the state's slow down move over law.
Make it a little safer for those workers along our roadways to get their job done.
One measure allows tow truck operators to use blue flashers like the ones on police cars, and the other requires greater notice and education about slow down move over. A state senator says a Democratic bill before a Senate committee doesn't go far enough regarding emergency orders issued by Washington's governors. Kimberly Wirtz explains.
Senator Linda Wilson says two measures she has filed would better balance the roles of the legislative and executive branches during a state of emergency.
That's the way our government is set up, right? We're supposed to be representing our constituents, and our Constitution says that we should be doing that. And it shouldn't be run by one person. Regardless of who the governor is, it shouldn't be run by just one person.
The Vancouver Republicans' bipartisan legislation now appears stalled as the current state of emergency nears the 700-day mark. Wilson says the Democrat bill still in play won't give legislators the authority they should have to end or extend emergency orders.
There's nothing that allows the legislators to come to the table. So the bill really doesn't do much of anything.
But she says it's a start, and she hopes to add amendments to give it some teeth. I'm Kimberly Wirtz.
A state senator seeks accountability from a failure-plagued state agency. It's just the latest issue at the Employment Security Department. ESD says the paid family medical leave fund is set to run out of money. Senator Ron Mazzal wonders why legislators are just now learning about this.
Why didn't they come to us last session and say, hey, this is not working. We need to raise this in order to take in more money to make this program sustainable.
The Yokarba Republican says it's like giving a college student enough money for the quarter.
And they come to you halfway through the quarter and say, oh, I spent it all the first week and now I need more money.
Mazzal says ESD has been plagued by one failure after another, and this is another example of disappointing mismanagement.
They lost $800 million to offshore scammers. Now I've got constituents receiving letters from ESD saying, oh, we overpaid you by $16,000. We need it back. They don't have it to pay them back.
Mazzal says there's a serious need for the legislature to impose some strict accountability going forward. Do you think your child should be required to get the COVID vaccine to attend school? Senator Mark Schessler wants you to know about a State Board of Health survey on the topic.
This is about transparency and public participation rather than hiding it on the backside of a web page or the legals in the newspaper.
The Ritzville Republican says he and his colleagues receive many calls and emails from constituents on this issue. Schessler says it's important parents and caregivers give input regardless of if they support or oppose a vaccine requirement.
I want people at the end of the day to know that a state agency listened, heard them, and made a decision rather than operating in a cloud of secrecy.
You can find a link to the survey in this news story on Senator Schessler's website and at the State Board of Health website. A plan to crack down on catalytic converter theft. State Senator Jeff Wilson's bill aims to stop scrapyards from buying stolen catalytic converters.
Catalytic converter theft is the crime of the day. It's affected everybody in Washington State. We must do something to begin to slow this theft down.
Under the Longview Republicans' legislation, those those who knowingly buy or receive stolen catalytic converters would face misdemeanor charges.
This is not anything other than an epidemic. It is probably the most increased crime of over 470% since last year alone.
Those are some of the things that happened this week in Olympia. Find us online at src.wastateledge.org. Follow us on YouTube and Twitter at WashingtonSRC, on Facebook at Washington Republican Senate Caucus, and on Instagram at WasSenRepublicans. I'm Tracy Ellis. This is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Senate Republican Caucus.